Once again, I welcome you to this congregation in the capital city of United States of America, Washington, D.C. Wisdom from the sands of time. Wisdom from the sands of eternity. The third talk for this afternoon is entitled Benediction of Silence. Benediction of Silence. Silence is beautiful only if it is rooted in awareness. Awareness gives silence a depth, plenitude, a fulfillment, contentment, and finally an overflowing joy. With awareness, silence blossoms and releases great fragrance. Without awareness, the silence is utterly empty, dark, dismal, and sad too. Silence has been praised down the ages by the sages, masters, sheikhs, and people from all walks of life. Silence is one of the most important factors for inner transformation. Silence is one of the most important factors for inner transformation. But silence alone is neither enough nor beneficial. Silence alone can be tremendously harmful. Silence alone is a negative state. It can make you more dead than you are. It can destroy the joy of being, the joy of inner being. It can destroy the joy of inner being. It can be an obstruction for the growth of a celebrating soul. Silence is beautiful only if it is rooted in awareness. And if it is not rooted in awareness, then it is utterly empty. Awareness gives silence a depth, plenitude, a fulfillment, contentment, and finally an overflowing joy. With awareness, silence blossoms. With awareness, silence blossoms and releases tremendous fragrance. Without awareness, the silence is utterly empty, dark, dismal, and sad too. Silence can be either of the cemetery or of a sunrise. Silence can be of a word. Silence can be of a bird on the wing, or it can be that of a corpse. Both are silences, but diametrically opposite. The silence of a corpse has to be avoided, while the silence of a flower has to be imbibed. The silence of the flower will make you a flower. The silence of a corpse will make you a corpse. Both look alike from outside. Never be deceived by the appearances. Always look for the essential, for the very core. Two things can appear similar from the outside and maybe just the opposite to each other from it within. The seeker has to be very cautious, very conscious on each step, because the false is easy to attain. It is very easy to become dead and very difficult to be overflowing with life. This is why millions of monks and nuns have followed a false path. They have become silent. You can go to the monasteries and you will find people who are silent, but their silence has the taste of death. Their silence is not the silence of a song or of a dance. Their silence is not divine. In fact, they have fallen rather than risen higher, soaring upward. They have fallen so much that they have become just lifeless rocks. Their silence has not become, has been a transformation. It has been suicide. And because it has not been soaring up high, you will find all kinds of foolishness is still waiting for their opportunities to explode in the moments of unconsciousness. In soaring up high, you will find all kinds of foolishness is still waiting for their opportunity to explode in the moment of unconsciousness. The foolish person can become silent. It may deceive many. They may think he has arrived, but he is simply hiding his foolishness, his stupidity, and his unconsciousness behind a beautiful facet of silence. I have heard an ancient Sufi parable. Four disciples decided to go into silence. They moved into a cave. They wanted to live in silence for 3 months. Because they had heard so much about it, as they had become so much intrigued, they were so ambitious to gain something out of it. However, without understanding, they had brought them to the cave. It was greed, desire, and ambition too. Hence, within minutes, everything was exposed. Just within minutes, the first man said, I wonder whether I have put the candle out or not. It will be a sheer wastage. There is nobody in the house. The second one said, you fool, you have spoken, and we had taken the vow of silence. The third one laughed. The third one laughed and said, you are a greater fool. If he had spoken, what was the need for you to speak? What was the need for you to speak? And the fourth one said, thank God, I am the only one who has not spoken yet. And see what happens. It was the moment of unconsciousness. All the four forgot what they had been there for. They spoke. I have heard this story differently as a child. And for now, I have rephrased it differently. Just by being silent, nothing changes. You remain the same within. Transformation comes through awareness. Awareness brings a silence of its own, very alive, throbbing with eternity, and full of song and a dance. It is not sad and not serious because it is not dead. Only a dead person is serious. It has a dance of it. It is tremendously beautiful. It is positive and existential too. It does not make you just a hollow thing. Instead, it makes you so full that you start overflowing with joy. You become so fulfilled that you cannot contain your contentment. You cannot contain your contentment within yourself. You have to share it. You become a cloud full of rain water. You have to shower it. This is what a master does. He shares his inner silence, and in that state, inner beauty, harmony, and silence overflows as words. This is what is meant by the word Upanishad. Upa, it comes from three words, Upa, Ni and Shad. Upa means sit, Ni means close, and Shad is home. Together this means come and sit close to me. Such overflows are scriptures. All scriptures have happened in that, in such a state. But out of 100 so-called seekers, only once in a while there is a rare seeker that comes to know the difference between the real silence and the unreal silence. How can the fool within you be dropped by being silent? Yes, it will not be expressed, but it will be there. In fact, it will become more and more powerful. Unexpressed, it will accumulate energy. And any moment, any opportunity, and you will show it. You will be unable to hide it forever. Therefore, be aware of it. Imbibe the silence that overflows and surrounds the master. In such communion, your inner unconsciousness and foolishness too will dissolve one day. In such communion, in the company of a master, in the company of the living Buddha, hello. Yeah, she has about 200 and something pieces. Children one. What I will do, I will give it to the lady from Shagwana's. Okay. No, but what happened that day? Let us not discuss that day. Okay. In the company of a living master, in the company of a living Buddha, in such communion, your inner unconsciousness and foolishness too will disappear, will dissolve one day, and you will attain to a state of awareness, blissfulness. So, this is it for now. Let us now enter into meditation to imbibe these words within, to imbibe this silence.